that was so easy. All right. I'm going to talk to you girls today about something that the Lord has done. It is so cool. I think you're going to like it. All right. Each of you is going to take one of these. They're pieces of coral. Came out of the ocean here. Those are going to be symbolic. Grains of sand. So it's kind of big, but you're big. So compared to shrimp, that's about the size of a grain of sand. Shrimp are very interesting. If you think about us sitting here today, how do you know that you're sitting upright? How do you know you're sitting upright and not upside down? You can feel the gravity, can't you? All right. The Lord created shrimp with no sense of up or down. So they don't know if they're up or down, except that He did give them something really neat that they do. Shrimp molt, just like any other crustacean, I guess, or where they shed their skins like cicadas and things like that. So as the shrimp grows, it will shed off its skin and it'll grow a new layer of skin over the enlarging body as the shrimp gets bigger and bigger. But what shrimp will do is they will take a piece of sand from the seafloor and they will put it on top of their heads. Go ahead and put your sand on top of your head. Hold it right there. Okay, make sure it stays. Okay, and what they'll do then is the new layer of skin will grow right over that piece of sand. And as it does it, go ahead and grab it. As it does it, that sand will rest in a certain spot on top of their head, and the gravity will pull it down, and they will know that if they're in the surf and they're being tossed to and fro, they'll know how to right themselves properly because the sand will sit on top of their head properly. Do you know how they found this out? No. Some scientists said, you know, I think this is what the shrimp are doing. So they filled a pool with metal filings in it only. No sand, just metal filings. And they put the shrimp in there, and as the shrimp molted, they grabbed little pieces of metal filings, put it on top of their head, covered it over with the skin, and then they took a huge electromagnet right over the top of the tank, and they turned it on. And that electromagnet made the metal filings do what? Right up to it, didn't it? And all the shrimp immediately went thunk upside down and swam around the water. And then they took some shrimp from the ocean and they dropped one of them in there. So they had a whole bunch of shrimp swimming around upside down, and then there's this one little guy swimming around correctly looking at him like, what are you guys doing? That reminds me of a story in the Bible. And it's a passage in Romans 12:2. Thank you. And it reads, "And be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is good and acceptable and perfect, and the perfect will of God." So that little shrimp that was swimming correctly, and a sea of shrimp that were swimming upside down, reminds me of kind of the way this world works. We think we know what's right in this world. A lot of people think they know what's right. And when you come to know Jesus, and there are several of you today that are baptized, you know who Jesus is, and you walk differently than the rest of the world, don't you? And sometimes it's kind of like you're the only one that's upside down, but really you're the one who's right side up. And the whole world is upside down, and they're going to look at you sometimes, and they're going to say, who do you think you are? Why do you think you're better than me? Do you think you're better than anybody else? But you're different. That's the reality. So as you go through this life, you may have people ridicule you for swimming upside down compared to everybody else. But the truth is, you've got something special.
Amen.
And if you allow Jesus into your heart, maybe you'll lead some of them to get rid of their metal filings and choose the same for Jesus too. Okay? All right, you can go back to your seat.